Deontay, it's the last time that we're going to ask you to do this. I know you particularly are sick of the media this time around. You can have your opportunity to give your final comments.
What more that I can say that hasn't already been said, you know? I just tell you guys to prepare yourself on the battlefield and get ready for war. Because this is right here, this is going to be an amazing fight come October the 9th. And as you see, I'm wearing my red outfit, so I want it back in blood. And I'm looking forward to it. And I'll see you guys there.
Tyson, you're up.
Well, I've got a lot to say, actually. Here's something that I think I need to say. It's like, Wilder said that I only won the second fight because I cheated. But then he goes and changes his whole team and does all this extra training and trains as hard as he's ever trained and brung on all his team and all that. So I ask the question is, if I only won because I cheated, what was the point in changing everything and doing all this other work? Can anybody answer that question? I know he can't, doesn't have the brains to. So, no one can answer that question, can they? So, the fact that I've egg in your face, bitch, is the word. That's what we say. And here's another one. He says he wants to do bad things to me and hurt me and do all this malice feelings, and he's got anger and aggression. Well, for those who hold a hot coal with the intentions of throwing it at somebody, guess what? They're the ones who's going to get burnt. I don't want to hurt Deontay Wilder. I just want to beat him in a fight. And he knows what he's saying is lies. And deep down in his soul, he knows that he lost. And he'll lose again. And he lost the first time, he lost the second time, and he's gonna lose the third time. And guess what? After this fight, he'll be back working in that fast food chain that he was working at early on in his career. Because that's the only place he's gonna be.
It's easy to answer.
Retirement, Dosser.
The answer to your question is why you changed for the first and second.
No, that ain't the answer to the question. That's another question. So that's not an answer. If I only won because I cheated, why do all this extra training?
Why you change the person's set?
As long as I didn't
cheat. So ask yourself that question.
You go ask yourself the question. I've done all this cheating.
I see nervous energy.
Yeah? Then why has he not prepared himself? He hasn't done any extra steps at all to stop me from cheating again.
Why you explain yourself?
I'm not explaining myself. I'm asking you a question.
You haven't denied any allegations to this point.
I don't need to deny it because it's true.
You know what I'm saying? You haven't denied any allegations.
I had a turbo jet on me.
You don't even want certain media in here to give you the tough questions. You have nobody to give you the tough questions.
There's nobody in here that can ask me a tough question.
So when it's like that,
you're in denial and you're getting knocked out.
Yeah, let's make it.
And then you're going to retire. Retire.
You don't know nothing about knocking no one out. You don't have knockout power.
Your legacy's in bits.
Even in my worst times, you still hit like a bitch.
No one's even believed you. I didn't feel anything. People wondering why I kept getting up and getting up. Because I didn't feel nothing.
You have no power. You're not a knockout artist.
I'm not a knockout artist. I got one out on my feet. That's a lockout.
I had a disloyal trainer to throw the towel in.
Dosser.
And guess what? When someone throw the towel in after the boss tells them not to do, the employee gets fired.
Yeah, but you said I have knuckle dusters on. JD is in the room while I had the fucking guts on.
Why didn't he say something then?
He's in on it too.
Don't worry about him. I handle my team. You handle yours like you handle yours.
You're a weak man. Thank you.
I'm the only one that defended my title 10 times. I've gone out in history as six. How many times have you defended? I don't have to cheat. I never had to cheat in years.
I've come here.
You look up your history and you look up my history, which I advise everyone to do your homework. You look up you and you look up me. I'm a nun in this sport, baby.
You ain't going to manipulate my gloves. I don't have to do those things. You have to do it all. So at night, when I look into the mirror, I mean, train pilot, I'm going to kill you. And you're going to knock out inside. No problem. I don't care, because your life is a problem. And if I don't stop another glove, doesn't my life? I'm good. That's the difference between me and you. I don't have to fire another damn mouth.
Doesn't matter.
Because your legacy's already finished. All the excuses have been done. You've been beat. You've been humiliated. And you've been busted. End of. And that's it. there's no one in here can accept the fact that this little pussy got his ass handed to him, not once, but twice, and he can't do nothing about it!
Because
he ain't fucking man enough!
I accept it. I accept it. Look.
Tell him what to say, Shelly, come on. Tell him what to say.
When I was in the condition that I was in, I could have stopped before. I could have went back to my corner, but you know what? I'm accepting what I was going through to still fight you.
Yeah, you look like a dosser.
I still accepted it. And you still couldn't knock me out. You still couldn't do it.
You look like a dosser.
But guess what?
If the roles were reversed
and you was in the situation I was in, they would have called 911.
You're trainer, Jay Diaz.
Someone please call
911. He saved your life that night.
I don't know.
You didn't want to sack him. You wanted to give him a pay rise. A pay rise.
So why is he terminated?
He needed a pay rise.
I'm willing to die in the ring.
I don't know how wise this is, but we all get blasted.
I'm willing to die in the ring, so it ain't no saving my life. That's why I do the things outside of the ring. And my family have an understanding. My children have an understanding that daddy has a dangerous job. And there's no other sport in this world that have collected as many lives as boxing.
Amen.
So I understand what I'm going through.
And we respect both of you for those reasons. And I ask both of you.
I don't respect this.
Deontay, will you do us a favor? Can you stand up? We're going to do a face-off one final time. We have a huge show coming up for you on Saturday night. Massive respect. No, we're not going to do. I apologize. No. Paul Barron says no. Paul Barron says no. All right, we're going to leave it there. Listen, we do have a television show still coming up. Deontay, I appreciate you. Thank you very much, sir. It's good to see you.
Hell yeah!
Tyson, I appreciate you. Thank you very much. It was good to see you.